Hello and welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. Today we have something a little bit different. We have this Elite 2 controller which has its usual bumper problems. However, the customer has been shopping and they have bought the goods. We have a Halo limited edition shell, brand new from AliExpress, including all the ancillary bits and pieces. So once we've corrected this, whoa, just realised, don't know if you can see that, but that right stick is, whoa, right off. So yeah, this is going to need sticks as well as bumper. So the customer has actually said, RB button issue, needs attention, I tore a wire that goes to the rumble motor. Yeah, this customer is going to need sticks, bumpers and anything else that is not in great condition. First things first, let's have a look at the component parts that come with this Halo shell. So we've got the rear shell and we've got the faceplate. Close your ears if you don't like the sound of cracking plastic. There we go. So it's got a new inner frame, which I don't think is necessary. I'm not entirely sure. It's going to be a standard frame. I will check that. Yep, and we have the faceplate there, which is all nice and new. And we have all of the bits and pieces. So there's some special blue bits and a few other different accent pieces. I think the actual ABXY buttons are actually standard Elite. Yeah, they are. There's nothing too different about those. So we have all the pieces. What we need to do now is to test this controller, confirm problems, rectify the problems, and then during final assembly, put it all into here. Got the controller plugged in and we're on the tester. Let's turn the profiles off. So not even, it just acts as a standard controller now when the profiles are off. So no rear paddles, no funky triggers or anything like that. So on the whole, buttons feel good and they work. Analogs are drifting like crazy. So left one down, axis one, we get 13 down and we get 13 left and 13 right, give or take. So that is worn out, and that is actually on medium tension. So put it onto the lowest setting and it's even worse, 16, 17 down now. And this is on the highest tension, so let's put that on the lowest. So we're 9 down on axis 3, 15 up, 13, 15, 10 right, 10 that way. So yeah, these sticks are completely worn out, and as you can see here, this one is actually cocked over. So you got all of that unsprung slop in these sticks, which is typical Elite behavior. But yeah, no good at all. Yeah, they work all good and surprisingly well actually. Cool. And the bumpers, as the customer said, it was RB. These can work, appear to work perfectly fine, but after an hour's use you will find that they will start to intermittently fire. No good at all. Usually you can get it to fail if you crunch it in quite hard. Not failing. So now we've confirmed the issues with this controller and we've found a few more as usual. Let's get it apart and rectify each one individually. It's very important that these buttons fall back into the recesses under their own weight. These ones do, but they are definitely chunky, not great. So they will need a clean. And there we have it. We have the controller stripped down to its component parts. It makes more sense now why the customer has given us a brand new inner frame, because this one is in a little bit of a state. So we've got some marks going on there. That wouldn't really matter too much at all. However, this has got a big chunk taken out of it. Should look like that, but looks like that instead. It's very dirty, so yeah, I don't have to clean it, so that can go to one side. So we've got a brand new frame. I've had to take the trigger frames off, so we've got the pins and the springs to go with them. We won't be needing them because the Halo kit comes with a new set of them. We need the spring for the D-pad. We won't be needing the actual D-pad because the kit comes with one of them. We won't be needing the profile selector, again, comes with. We don't need to clean any of these buttons because we're going to get all brand new buttons, brand new LBRB and the center section. It's all new. What else? We get a new sync and guide button. Cool, that can go. I've had to take the locating pins out of the old shell. So those do need reinstalling. I'll just put them in now while I'm thinking about it. Cool, those pins are in. The trigger rumble motors, because that's got a broken wire, not bothered about that. Chuck him to one side. This one is unbroken and he's perfectly fine. So we'll get a spare one out of the box here. In fact, I've got two new ones here. They're already tied together, so put that to one side. So we've got them. The button rubber is in good condition, although a little bit grubby and shiny, but that is perfectly serviceable. We need to remove these two switches and also these two analogs and just give this board a bit of a clean. We also need to strip out the rear shell. We'll do that towards the end. I think the best thing to do right now is to rebuild this inner frame so this is ready to accept the boards as they are being repaired. So let's get on with that. Okay, so now we have the triggers installed, let's get the rumble motors and caps in. And there we have the basic triggers installed. There is a foam pad just here for the guide button, so we will be transferring that. That cleaned up quite well. We'll get in there with a Q-tip. And there we go, finally. After some brain farting around, I actually got these triggers on correctly. Yeah, can't explain that. That's just me being me. They were very fiddly and quite difficult to put them pins in. So yeah, that just sent my brain a little bit haywire. But we do have the basics here all set and ready to go. So we can put this to one side. And at this point, let's work on these two boards. First of all, let's clean them, get them mounted up, get these faulty components off, new ones on, and take it from there. And there we have the basic frame all set, ready to go. So all the buttons work and click nice. Everything feels nice and solid, and as it should. So yep, that's ready to accept the analog board. So we'll move on to that next. We have the analogs out of the analog board. So this is almost ready to accept some new analogs. I just need to clean off the plastic here from the from hot airing them off. I always now check this area here for any type of corrosion or water damage, anything like that, because this is a notorious area for getting water damage, and also it's the power area for the main CPU, so weird things can happen when there is problems here. So we'll just get this under the scope and take a quick look and see what we can see. And looking at this board now, I can see that this cap here does not look happy. Try and get some zoomage on that. So if you look at all of these other smaller caps, that one, I mean, even these two next to it, see how discolored he is? And if we look on the side here, right, it's going to get a little shaky. Try and keep it steady as I can. But we are super zoomed in here. Look, we have something there. See that brown muck, schmoo, whatever it is? Look at that. So that is causing that capacitor to overheat, and which is why he looks so dull. So it's probably partially corrosion and or overheating. So let's mount this board up and see if we can just rectify that. Okay, hopefully you can see that now. And we've got some muck coming out of it there. Yeah, that's sticky. So yeah, that's more corrosion than anything else, because as I'm scraping on it, it's shining up. I'm just wondering if that needs a clean and some fresh solder and flux on it. So let's do that and see how he fares up. I think he's going to be all right. I don't think I need to replace that. Okay, sort of looks a little bit better. A little bit on the squiff, but if you ignore him being slightly squiffy, he's actually looking a little bit better than the others. So, we'll roll with that. If we see any sort of spurious problems, we'll come straight back to that, whip him off the board, whang another one on there. Here we are with the controller in a partially assembled state. I'm just using the old back because we still haven't transferred all of the Halo parts over to this one. So we will just give them a quick test. Don't worry too much about the analogs because they're not soldered in just yet. I just want to test the buttons and they all feel good and they are responding great after the cleaning. Everything feels as good as it should. D-pad is spot on. Feels really nice. Okay, cool. So we'll carry on with the analogs, and then once they're all calibrated and soldered in correctly, we'll move on to the rear shell. We're getting an audible click out of the left one, but not so much the right one. These are the heavy action switches, so we should get a bit more of a hair trigger type snap to them. They don't feel right to me. I'm going to swap them out again. You have to bear with me on this, I'm sort of backtracking on myself here. I hate having to remove switches without removing the entire board because Oh, it's just such a pain in the arse, and you can rip the pad so easy if you're not versed in it. However, I just decided to be lazy there because I've got to be backtracking myself, and I don't want to disassemble the entire controller just to get to them switches. So, yeah, do as I say, not do as I do. To be honest, the time it took to disassemble it was probably negligible. Okay, so we've got these switches out. Put some new ones in, and then we'll check how they feel before soldering them up, because I don't know if it's the switches that I installed. I mean, sometimes you get one switch that feels a little bit dead, but not both of them at the same time. So it's either the switches that were, both of them were iffy, or it's just the fact that it's a different molded plastic and the angles are a little bit different. So let's replace this with two new ones and then check the action before we solder them in. So we're sort of going off the beaten track here a little bit. I mean, this really is why I disassemble the controllers, just to do these LBRB switches, because they can be a bloody nightmare. Let's just clean them holes out. Okay, so they're in loosely now. This back on. Okay, that sounds and feels a hell of a lot better. That's what I was expecting. So maybe I just soldered them in slightly wonky. I don't know. This right one does feel a little bit tighter than the left. Only marginally. Fully seated. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna go with that. Ah, that was totally worth the headache. So we'll get these soldered in, and then just imagine ourselves about 20 minutes ago, and yeah, carry on from there. Good, nice, even click. Yep, I'm happy with that. Good. Excellent. I mean, it would have been just so tempting to just send it the way it was. One making a nice loud click and the other one clicking. You can hear it, but it's just not the same.
Nice.
Gone as far as we can with this mid-frame. We now need to turn our attention to the rear shell. So we have the brand new Halo rear shell, and we have the old one, so we just transplant from one to the other. And let's get on with that. Thank you. I'll just make sure that those magnets are in the correct orientation. This should just snap into place, and it does. Cool. Before I forget, we need to transfer some more sponges. Here we are with the old shell and the new shell, and we've completely scrapped out the old one. There is nothing on that shell at all. Everything has been transplanted over to this one. I've tested the paddles and the trigger locks work as expected, so this is complete and looks really nice. So we're seeing the light at the end of the tunnel now. So next thing to do is to marry this up with the inner frame, calibrate the sticks and close him up. You know what I forgot to do? Silly me. The magnets out of the D-pad. They haven't given you, there's no magnets in here. You have to take these magnets out and transplant them in there. Totally forgot. Back to 5 minutes ago. I have actually repaired an actual one of these, bought one, and these shells and these parts are genuine. They're not third party, definitely not third party. The quality of them is just too high. They are the exact shells. So yeah, that's cool. So that just needs a bit more testing. So I've got to test the audio socket, we'll get it on the Xbox, get it updated, make sure that the battery's charging through the wireless, I've got to do it every time, wireless dock, and just give it a full check over, make sure the profiles are loading and deleting and all of that jazz. So yeah, that's cool. And that will conclude this video. So as always, really appreciate you watching, and take care.